Hello. Thanks for joining. My name is Raju. Today, I'm going to show you how you can create interactive emails with an Outlook using adaptive cards. How many of you here have heard of like actionable messages? Ah, great. Have you been building one as well? Ah, awesome. For the rest of you, it's a very simple yet powerful technology. Let me show you what it is. If you're like me, you'd be receiving tens of dozens of emails, ranging from expense reports to task notifications. Yet, most of these are static in nature. You click on a link, you authenticate, and you perform certain actions on a different service. Every such hop to a different application ruins your productivity, and like you end up losing your focus. What if you could approve an expense report or complete a task as complete, my market task as complete, right from within your email? Well, that's what actionable messages enable you to do. And today, we are happy to announce full support for adaptive cards within the Outlook actionable messages technology. So here, you see a simple actionable message from GitHub. So as a user, I can add a comment or even close the issue right from within my email without having to use the GitHub app or go to the website. Building an actionable message is extremely easy. All it takes is three simple steps. First, you design your card, then you send it to yourself, and finally, you wire up actions. Let's see how to do it. I'll give a live demonstration by building a simple actionable expense report. So to do that, you head out to dev.outlook.com/actions. So this is the documentation homepage for all of Outlook actionable messages. It has all the necessary information and links, including like the developer dashboard as well as the card playground that you need to reference. So you only need to remember this one single link, dev.outlook.com/actions. So to design my card, I head out to the card playground. It is an interactive playground. You see on the left-hand side, there is an adaptive card JSON payload and like a sample card that has been like completely crafted out of this JSON. I can flip through various templates that are available in this environment. I can pick and choose one of these, or I can design my card from scratch. I'm going to design my expense card from scratch. So I have like an empty adaptive card here. I'll go ahead and add a simple text block element. So as soon as I add,
we need to zoom.
So as soon as I create the text block element, you would see the preview right there. So now I'm going to add a simple approve button onto my card. So to do that, I add some actions. I'm going to call this action approve. Of the different actions that Adaptive supports, I'm going to use the HTTP action. I'll set the method to post and provide a REST endpoint where I would receive a HTTP post request when user clicks on approve. So for now, I'm leaving it TBD. Now that we have designed the card, I'm going to the next step, which is send this card to myself. The playground provides like a handy option here, send via email. When I click on this, I get an email right in my inbox, and I can see the card that I designed in the playground right there without any additional coding. So let's try to understand what exactly happens behind the scenes when I click on send via email. When I hit that button, the card that I designed is encapsulated within a script tag. This is a script tag of type application/adaptive cards plus JSON. And this script tag is added within the head section of my HTML email. So if you notice carefully, if your service already sends HTML emails, you don't have to go and rewrite your HTML. All you do is simply inject this script tag with the adaptive card JSON that you designed. Also, you wouldn't have to redesign your email delivery mechanism. You can continue to use what you already use today. As a developer, you can send an actionable message to yourself. But when you want to send actionable message to others, you need to register in our developer dashboard and get approved. So if you're trying to send actionable messages within your tenant, within your own organization, you would need an org admin consent. And if you want to send actionable message to everyone all over the world, you would need to get approval from our review team. So let's go ahead and add some action. So all I need here is a REST endpoint. I already have implemented a simple REST endpoint for the purpose of this demo. When I do a HTTP post to this endpoint, I get a 200 OK and an empty response. I'll go ahead and add this REST endpoint as my target URL here. So now when user hits approve, a HTTP post is going to be fired to this endpoint. So currently it returns nothing. I want it to return a different adaptive card. For that, I'm going to design yet another card. So I'll call this the refresh card. So instead of is available, I'll make it was approved. And in this instance, since the expense is going to be approved, instead of the approve button, I'll add a view button here. So I'll copy this adaptive card, go back to the REST endpoint that I established. I will add it in the body of the response payload. Okay? You would also notice that I have set a HTTP header. So this is card update in body, and I have set it to true. So this is the signal that is being sent to the client to understand that the REST endpoint is returning a different card, and it uses that to refresh the previous card that I had. Now let's try out how this works. I'll go ahead and send out the email again via email. If I head out to my Outlook client, I see the card here. Now when I click on approve, the card refreshes and shows was approved, and the approve button has been changed to view. So it's that simple. So this is how you build an actionable message end to end. Now let's understand how the actions work. So when you send, service sends the HTML email with the markup, it hits Office 365. Office 365 checks if you're an approved sender to be able to send actionable messages. It also does certain additional checks to ensure that the email is actually coming from you, your own servers, and not from someone else who's trying to spoof you. So if all these checks pass, the actionable messages relate to the end user. Users in Outlook Web and Outlook 2016 would be able to see the cards render. Those who use a legacy version of Outlook or other email clients such as like Thunderbird, Gmail, or Apple Mail, they would just continue to see the HTML part of your email. They wouldn't see the cards. So it's seamless. When a user clicks on the action, the HTTP post doesn't directly land on your service. It is relayed through Office 365 Actions middle tier. What it does is adds a bearer token. So this it's a standard JWT token, a JSON web token. When you validate this JSON web token, you can verify that this request actually came from Office 365, and no one else is like trying to like do a man-in-the-middle attack on your service. You would also have additional information, such as who actually performed the action. So you don't have to re-authenticate the user. Then your service sends a response in the form of a refresh card, a new adaptive card in this case, which is relayed back to the client. And when the client receives it, it goes ahead and refreshes the card. So it's as simple as that, and it's super safe and secure. So currently, we have built like a very simple card. But adaptive is like a more capable card format. It supports a whole range of components and actions. It even supports like rich text capabilities using Markdown. In addition to the core set of actions, it also supports certain actions which are like very specific to Outlook. You can have like a message form open up or like a launch an add-in, all of that right from within Outlook. So let's head out and create like a much richer card. To do that, instead of like crafting the JSON manually, To do that, instead of crafting the JSON manually, I'm going to use an adaptive card designer that we have been working on. So here I have the designer. It's currently in preview. So please forgive me if there are any glitches in the demo. So I go ahead and copy and paste the markup that they created. You would see like a preview of the card show up here. I can click on each of these elements and view the properties that I've already set. So let me go ahead and add some more actions. This time, instead of the HTTP action, I will add a show card action. I'll call it decline. When user clicks on a show card action, it shows another small adaptive card within. So let me go ahead and add like an input text element. So I'll use this to capture the comment, if any, that the user would enter when declining this expense report. I'll go ahead and add another action here. I'll call it the submit action. So after the comment is entered, I'll make it a HTTP post action. For this, I have created yet another REST endpoint similar to the one that I showed earlier. I'll use it here. Now when user hits submit, I want the information that he entered in the comment box to also be sent out. So to do that, I'll go and set the ID property of the input box and use that to create the body of my HTTP post. So to do that, I craft a simple JSON. And within double braces, I say comment text.value, comment text being the ID of the field that is right there. So this does a simple input substitution and creates crafts that JSON and sends along with my HTTP request. I can go ahead and add other actions as well. Like there are simple actions like open URL, which simply is a deep link into my service. I can call it view. So to enrich my card, I want to add the status of the current status of the expense report. To make it more prominent, I'm going to use an image. As soon as I add this URL of the image shows up right there. I can go ahead and adjust the size of the image. Now I want to add more details about who submitted the expense report, maybe like a profile picture and like the name of the person and more context around it. Further, I'm going to use a column set. Within a column set, I can add multiple columns. So here you see I have added like three simple columns. They are all equally spaced and of equal size because the width has been by default set to stretch. If I say auto, so it resizes itself depending upon the content that is right there. I add a simple image element to capture the person's profile picture. I go ahead and add the URL. I have the image right there. Now I go and add another text block where I can provide the name of the person. So I can add more such elements to add all the data that I need. So now that we have all the information, we can make it like more beautiful. So since this is like a person's profile picture, I can go and like change the style to person, in which case it automatically makes it a circular image. And I can even like reduce the size of the image to the size that I want. There is like too much spacing between these two lines. I can go ahead and eliminate that spacing so that they are closer together. I can increase the size of the text element to make this more prominent. I'll also make it bold. So if I want to highlight the person's name here, so I can do the same thing. When I set it to bold, the entire line becomes bold, but I specifically want the person's name to be bold. So in that case, I can use the rich markdown support that Adaptive Cards allows. So I'll go and add the markdown information to make it bold here. With two asterisks, I can make it like bold here. So as a final touch, I'll go ahead and add like the logo for our application. So we have like a much more beautiful looking card design. I'll take it back to the playground. I'll paste it here. So now, when user clicks on approve or decline, I also need to have like corresponding refresh cards, like the one that we designed earlier. So I'll go ahead and do that. I'll use the same card as the building block, and I'll just go and replace the pending image to approved. And since this is approved, I would no longer require the approve and decline buttons in the refresh card. So I'll go ahead and remove those. So now I have the refresh card for approved. I'll go and copy it as the in the response body of my REST endpoint. I'd create a similar response payload for the declined scenario. I'll copy that in the other REST endpoint that I've created. Now everything is ready. I'll go ahead and send this email to myself. So now, when I hit approve, the card refreshes to show approved, and the approve decline buttons are gone. And similarly, if I go ahead and do decline and provide some reason, again, the card refreshes. And if I go to inspect the actual request that came in, you would see the JSON that we crafted within the card. It says it provides the actual text that I entered there. So with Adaptive, you can create like very rich visual experiences within Outlook. So this is an example of like how rich it could be. You could have like expand collapse sections to show line items, have receipts as attachments to the same email. So you can provide like very compelling workflows right within your email client. So here are some partners that have implemented actionable messages, GitHub, Asana, and Limeade being the most recent ones. Coming to roadmap, so we would be making the Adaptive Card Designer available broadly very soon. Currently, we have the ability to refresh that entire card or a certain section within the card. We would soon be making available the ability to refresh the card even before the user has viewed it. Let's say the expense report was approved using a mobile app. So when the user views this mail for the first time, it wouldn't even show the approve decline buttons. It would directly go to the refresh card and say, hey, this was already approved using your mobile phone. So that would be possible. We would also start adding more native actions. And we would also power something called adaptive templates, wherein you don't even have to design an adaptive card for like the more common design elements that you need. You would simply send a schema.org type data object, and we would automatically pick the right card and start showing it within the appropriate lines. So I hope you had something useful to learn. So when you go back, think of all the scenarios where you can engage your users and others in your organization, and see how you can make the best use of adaptive cards and actionable messages. Thanks.